So, hi, Elaine. Thank you very much for coming on today to talk about how it was to work with me. I know that I'm not easy to work with, and I'm not for everyone, but the people that I do work with get a lot out of the sessions that we do. So today, I just want you to introduce yourself, tell people who you are, what you do, and yeah, let's just start with that for now.
Perfect. Oh, well, great to be here. You say you're not easy to work with. I don't think I'm easy to work with either. So that's maybe why we connected so well. So I am Elaine Atherton, and lovely to be here and sharing a little bit, what I got from your program. But so I'm a sales and accountability coach. And what that is essentially is I help small businesses get themselves on track with their sales. Because let's face it, most people, they don't start a business to become a salesperson. They start a business because they're an expert in their field, and
Yes.
the sales bit is a something that comes with it. So I help them get through the treacle and the mire of that in a number of ways. So essentially, it's some coaching, some training, and accountability is the bit that makes it all happen.
Amazing. Thank you. So let's get into it. What was the situation before you came to me? Like, I know that marketing isn't your best friend, let's be honest. Yeah. So what was the situation before you came to me? How were you feeling about it? What was the problem?
No, and such good question, because actually when I think back now, I can still feel how I felt, if you know what I mean. And yes, marketing's not my best friend. I do my marketing myself. And actually, as a sales coach, you sort of feel like you know a fair bit about marketing, but I also absolutely knew that I was missing some pieces here. And what I felt like the situation was when I came to you is I feel like I've sort of got the right things and the right offerings. I absolutely knew who my ideal clients were, but I was so going around in circles with it. And as we always know ourselves, is you can keep asking yourself the same questions, but you're absolutely going to come up with the same answers. And sometimes you've just got to step out of that and think, I need some help here. And that's exactly where I was. I knew for me to move forward, I needed some help with it. So I sought you out, Amanda.
Bless you. And what was it about me that made you go, she's the one? Because there's lots of people out there that do marketing, but what was it about me particularly?
Well, yeah, no, and again, another great question is I think that's the challenge, isn't it? Because there are lots of people who do what we all do. So, it's finding the person that is absolutely right for you. And for me, what I was looking for is someone that would be honest and not tell me what I needed to hear, but actually challenge my thinking. Because as I said before, I sort of knew the bits I was pretty good at, but actually I was lacking in certain areas, and I wanted that person to be able to identify that and give me some really good advice, direction, and question me really. And having met you, I knew you were that person. And equally, you were doing the holistic approach to it all, so it felt like it was me as a brand, not just my social media or one element of it. It was the helping me identify and pull all that together. And I had seen that you'd done that with other people, and that's why I was drawn to you.
Amazing, thank you. And I really appreciate that because marketing is a hard subject because there's so many different facets to it. And everybody has a different understanding of what marketing is. My understanding of it is as a whole. I look at marketing as the brand, the website, the person who's in the business as well, and lots of other things that attach them to that business to make it as successful as it can be. So I appreciate your words on that because that is one of the things. The holistic approach is one of the biggest things that I'm trying to, I'm not trying, I'm doing, driving home when it comes to how I market because I think it's really important. So moving forward, what were the tasks? Because I send out questionnaire and then I asked you certain questions. So what was it that you wanted me to help you with specifically? Like, I know it was the pulling it all together because you had all the bits, but what specifically was it that that you really wanted from the session?
Yeah, this is interestingly, when I went to you, I don't know what I expected really that bit to look like. I knew how I felt, which is, as I say to people, we invest our money when we want to take away some pain that we're feeling. Yeah. And I knew how I felt. I didn't really know what those tasks were going to look like. And of course, like everybody, you know, this my business is my baby, isn't it? As it is to all of us. So what you did for me is, you know, you got me to look at everything that I had, all the offerings that I had. You know, we honed in on my ideal client even further than I had, which was great. But also, it's, you know, how did the things align that I had currently, how did they align together? Did they work together? And it was that sort of clarity of, like, almost a bit like a flow chart, isn't it? Of how you meet people, which route do they come in, and what journey do you take them on? And it was that really, it was tough stuff, because it really got me thinking. And I know there was some tears and tantrums in that from my end. But you know, that was absolutely well worth going through that, because that's got me to where I am now, being really clear on all my offerings. And some I took away, thought, do I need that? No, I don't. So for me, big exercise, but absolutely just gave me so much clarity, and with that took away a lot of the overwhelm, the pain that I was feeling.
Amazing, just amazing. Because I remember when you came in, and most people who come and work with me for 3 months are a bit like, I have no clue what to expect, even though I try and explain the things that we're going to do, because I have a 7-step process that I go through, and we talk through what I call my loose leaf. It's a 36-page book that, depending on what business you're in, how you want to talk to your customers, offerings, all of those different kinds of things, this loose leaf gets put into a different order for every single person. So nobody gets a cookie cutter thing with me. It's like very bespoke for you and tailored for you. And so we start where you're ready to start, not where, you know, you don't need to start, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
And you've mentioned two amazing things. Number one, alignment. Like, that is my thing. Alignment is my thing. I talk about full alignment. And what I mean by full alignment is you as a business owner and the business, like, coming together and working so well that you're just attracting people. And the other thing that you talked about was the journey, the mapping, which is the specialty that I'm in, is how do you get people who don't know who Elaine is all the way through to recommending Elaine, referring Elaine, telling people about Elaine, telling them how amazing you are. So, yeah, you know, I'm so pleased that they're the things that you got out of it, because now you have those clear steps of what to do. And sometimes we do have too many offerings, don't we? Kind of like pile it all in, because we're kind of wanting to prove to people that we can do the job. And we have all of this stuff, but sometimes less is more. And actually it gets us better clients, more clarity, and a lot more other things.
Without question. I think we can't underestimate the clarity bit, really, because most, you know, of us who are doing our own social media, or even if we have a bit of help, you know, we've got to be giving the person doing it, or we've got to know exactly what we're saying and doing for it to be effective. And I think that you know, does come with its own challenges. If you're trying to do too many things, it actually just, you know, it doesn't get picked up at all. So for me, and I know people who I work with, you know, they feel the same about it. For me, that was just massive. And now I can look at it and think, I don't need to, you know, I've got a process now for doing certain things. And actually then that allows me to look at the stuff I want to create or be creative with and do other things. It's freed up a lot of headspace. Whereas before, my mind was totally taken up with, well, what should I do today? How should I do that? You know, all this based on the social media. I mean, you know, it was all a bit of a, oh, this is just giving me a headache. And actually now it doesn't feel that way. It feels like it's in its box. It's got its place. And, you know, it's happening.
Brilliant. Because I know so many business owners struggle with that. You know, the head is all over the place and it's kind of like, I've got all this stuff to do and all I want to do is the thing that I'm good at. Yes. I just want to do that thing.
Yeah.
And understanding your marketing before you give it to somebody else is essential. That's when people go through PAs and VAs and social people and it's not working, and it's not working because they don't understand their own marketing. And once you get that clarity, and you're so right. When I talk to people about the biggest thing that they're going to get from me is clarity.
Mm.
They're like, oh, okay. Because I think they just want me to talk about the activities. What should I do on social media? And what should I say on my blog? But actually it's much more than that. So again, thank you. So what were some of the actions that we took? What were some of the things that you did during those 3 months?
Yeah. Oh gosh. Well, I did review most aspects of all my materials, really. I really looked at that, which is time consuming, and but you know, absolutely vital to do it. And I, you know, what it's ironic, isn't it? What I, when I work with people, I, as a sales coach, I talk to them about, now you've done that, you've got to look at it through the eyes of your buyer, because that's your words now, you know, that you're putting there. But actually, if I was a potential client, how would that read to me? And so of course you did that to me, and that actually was a really powerful exercise, because it as I say to people, you can't do it effectively on your own business. You need someone outside to be objective, because you just can't do it yourself. And whilst I help other people with it, I needed that help. So that was really important. Once I sort of got onto the who am I, and you know, and there was times when I saw, you know, definitely doubted myself. I absolutely say that, and you picked me up and gave me some really, you know, not outside of your remit words, really, I would say, you know, not about marketing, but just about that self-belief of identity and who you are and who you're helping. And so I got a lot more than I anticipated, all in a positive way though.
Amazing.
So yeah, certainly lots of actions. And some of it was, you know, a bit of sort of self-awareness really as well, which was again, really powerful.
Thank you. And I think we need that. I think that is part of my differentiator, is that I bring that bit in, because it's not just about the doing, it's also about the being. So if we want our business to be as successful as possible, we have to be as successful. And what I mean by that is, you know, we have to wake up every day feeling good, wanting to work, wanting to go out, get those sales, speak to people. And if we're not in that space, it actually reflects in the business as well. So it is really important. So finally, let's talk about the results. What results did you get? Because everybody's different who works with me, depending on the size of business, how they work, all of this kind of stuff. So let's talk about results. What did you get from working with me over the 3 months?
Absolutely. And I think if I'm honest, it was when I was working with you, there were so many things for me to do that I'm absolutely the person who, will analyze and be self-critical. So I when I'd done the tasks, if you like, and the actions, there was more I wanted to do based on, I wanted to change some more things. So for me, I didn't see the results instantly, but I didn't expect to. And that wasn't why I, you know, signed up to work with you, because I just wanted to get my head in order, if you like, so then I could do this without the support, if you like. I was very clear then on where I wanted to go. So I actually, a few months later, I'd sort of finished everything I wanted to get done, felt right. And then I really started to see my business step up and up and up. And it was, it was obviously for me, it was that clarity of knowing who I was talking to, who I was helping, and actually knowing that when they looked at my website and they looked at all my offerings, that all was aligned and it all made perfect sense to the people, my potential buyers. And it was, the confidence was a big boost. There's no doubt about that. I feel so much more different about my business now. And the results are showing that, that my ideal clients are coming to me now, because I'm very clear on who I'm helping. So I couldn't be happier with the way things are going.
I am so proud of you. I really am. Cannot say, you know, we had some tears, you know, and I will say generally people do have tears with me. They have tears or they get really annoyed with me. Because I ask questions that most people won't ask. I'll go deep. And the reason for that is because, as I said, that relationship with your business, it's not just a business, it's a resource, and you both have to be working together as best as possible to get the result. And I absolutely love the fact that you carried on doing all the tasks, because I do give a lot of work. And, you know, sometimes time doesn't permit you to do it all at once. So I'm so proud that you carried on, you did it, and you've now got results. You've now got the people coming to you. And that is like the best that I could ever want for a client, because most people say, you know, I can't find my people. I don't know where my people are. My ethos is, let's not try and find them. Let them find you. Let us put these things in place so that they find you, they come to you. And it's happened. And I'm like, yes. So proud of you. And I just want to say, Elaine, thank you so much for going there. And doing the work, because it's in those two things, going there and doing the work, that actually get the results. We can't just do these superficial things, you know, the activities of marketing, without really understanding what you're here for, how you're going to achieve it, who you're going to achieve it with, and all of those things. So you were amazing to work with. And I just want to say thank you for choosing me.
Oh, no, honestly, it was a great decision on my part. And I totally recommend you. And I think, you know, again, as we said at the start, you know, are we all right for everybody? No, we're not. And I think, you know, you are absolutely right for me. And without doubt, for people who are, you know, are in a place where they just want someone to say it as it is and guide them through what they're missing and what we can look at and what we can change, and they're ready for it's that constructive feedback, isn't it, really, constructive criticism, you know, if you're ready for that to be able to do all those things, absolutely, you can make a huge difference to people's businesses. So thank you so much. You know, I really, really enjoyed the journey, and it's just made my life a lot easier.
good. And finally, I just want to ask, how do you feel about marketing now? Because before, you actually used the H word. You were like, I hate it. I don't want to do it. So how do you feel about it now? Is it kind of getting to be a best friend? Or is it still a bit like, you know, what's the relationship with that now?
Yeah, it's a weird one. I think when you're in sales, you know, you can dip into marketing relatively easy, I'd say, easier than some people. And, you know, I think that's why a lot of people get it confused, don't they? They think, oh, we do one of the same. So I think how I feel about it now is I don't get as hung up about it. And, you know, I'm LinkedIn sort of my best friend. That's where I put my, you know, posting and things and get my connections and clients from mainly. So for me, I just don't get hung up about it now. It's not that stressy, oh, what if I don't do this or what if I don't do that? I actually feel like if I just keep turning up, what if I miss the day? Does it matter? No, it doesn't matter. You know, it's building that reputation and not stressing over it. So I feel a lot more chilled about it. And I certainly don't, I don't hate it as much as I did. I think it's fair to say that I absolutely don't. Yeah.
that's, you know, that's good, you know, because a lot of people don't like marketing. You know, it's one of those things that it's a necessity. But I'm never going to say that I'm going to help you love marketing, but I want you to be better friends with it so that you guys can work together. So thank you. You know, I appreciate you doing this interview, and I appreciate you choosing me as well.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you for all your help and support.
Fabulous.